Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. And for this video, we'll be designing this logo. And if you look at this, it has got a basic shape of triangle with it got some certain thickness. And in the center, we can see an icon of a house which has got nice reflection and some glossy effect. Overall, the logo has been given some nice green color and finally the text. So to create this logo, we'll follow only four steps. First, we'll create the basic structure of this logo, which will include only the basic triangles. And second, we'll create this small pieces by using some simple steps. Third, we'll add the creation color and the glossy effect, and finally with the text. So to design this logo, we'll use the star tool that's in the polygon palette and left click your mouse button, and you got a palette of star. And in this radius one, fill it with some 50 points, in the radius 200 points, and keep the points around 3 because we are making triangles. So click that OK and you got a rectangle. Now we'll rotate it to an angle, so we'll rotate this like that with the shift press, just rotate it and you got a triangle. Now we'll make sure that the solid color is no color and the stroke color should be maybe black or any dark color. Now fill the stroke thickness to around maybe 40 or maybe 42, just check it out and duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and scale it down with the shift and alt press. Now reduce the stroke thickness around maybe 20 and just make sure it's in the center of the triangle. So we'll just push it down with the arrow keys and zoom it in. If it's required a manual adjustment, just click and do the manual adjustment and make sure the gap between the two pieces are constant from every angle. When you get that, just increase the thickness of the bigger one around 40. And this one just reduce, let's try some reducing the angles, reducing the thickness and make sure the thickness, okay fine, this much is good. We have given the stroke points of this, the stroke thickness to be 18 and the bigger one around 40, so that's fine. Now fill the inner piece with a solid color like black, and now select everything, go to object, expand. And the reason why we are using expand is to create this strokes into object form so that we can fill it some green color. So make sure the fill and stroke is ticked and click OK. Now select the inner piece, go to Pathfinder, just combine it. So we got two pieces of solid color, solid objects. Now next thing to do is to create this small pieces, and to create that we'll use the line segment, and from here select, click and just drag and place it here. Now fill some stroke color, maybe any color, increase the thickness so that we can see that, maybe a little bit smaller. Now just click and bring this stroke till here and make sure these sides overlaps each other, so just overlap there. Now go to selecting these line segment, go to object path and divide object below. So you can see it has divided object into pieces, so you can then group it. This part is different, this part is different. The same way we'll do all the rest of this stuff. We use the line segment tool and draw out a line segment. Fill it with some any color. And with the selection tool, just bring it in and place it there. And make sure these edges overlap. So just bring it in and make it overlap. Like that. Now go to object, path, divide object below, and this will divide that. Now we'll need one more here, so we'll do that. So with line segment, we'll just draw the line, one more. With the selection tool, just bring it in and place it there. And make sure the same stuff, overlapping. Okay, now go to object, path, divide object below. Now every pieces are separate, you can see it's separate. So now next thing is to make sure we'll create this gap, and we can see that the gap between the two pieces are equal to the thickness of this object. So we'll do that. So duplicate this, alt, and just drag it out and place it there. Now make sure its edges are overlapping, fine line like that. Now we'll just drag it out a little bit because we don't need that gap here, so we'll just make sure it's here only and just zoom it in and place it properly in the same. Now select this piece and make sure it's arranged to front. because we need the front object to be deleted from the lower one. So select both of them, subtracted. So we got subtracted, and here we go. Now, here's one more thing we need to do. We need to create that small house. So with the rectangle tool selected, just select, click from here and just drag it out and make sure it like this. Draw the rectangle like this, because we need these points touching each other like that. Select this and with the shift press just push it up a little bit so that we can create some windows here. So let's give space here. Now with this, now draw one more rectangle that should be from here, and just select this and just subtract that, so we don't need that piece here. Now select both of them and combine it. Now let's create the window. So to create the window, we'll use the rectangle, and from here just draw the rectangle and make sure its fellow color is white. Now with the selection tool, just scale it down. With the Alt press, you can manually do that like this. Now duplicate this, Control C, Control F, and with the Alt press, just click, drag in there and give some thickness to this. So select this, Control C, Control F, duplicate it one more time and just rotate it to an angle. So rotate it with the shift pressed, and now with the Alt press, just drag it out. And now select both the pieces and go to Pathfinder and combine it, and now select this and just subtract it. So you got the window. Now the next step is to add these gradient colors, so we'll do that. We'll select these two pieces with the eye press, that's the eye picker, and with shift and alt press just click this color. With the selection tool, select the object with the eye picker, select this object. Same with the eye picker, with the selection tool select these two pieces, and with the eye picker, shift and alt press, select this color. This is the color for that. Now select the house with the eye picker, shift and alt pressed, select this color. We'll do some gradient adjustment here with the select gradient tool. Just make sure the darker is here and lighter is there. In the same way, select this, G for the gradient and V for the selection tool. Same here. The same way, select this, G for the gradient, and just adjust few stuff like that. Now select this, G from top to bottom. Select this with a G from top to bottom. So for the house, we'll do some adjustment with the gradient color G, just from the top. First with the selection tool, select this, and with the G from the top to bottom like that. And you will get the yellow color on top and darker orange color on the top down. So after that, we'll duplicate this one more time, Control C, Control F, and we'll draw out a ellipse tool. With the ellipse tool, draw the circle like that and place it here. Now select that circle and this piece and just intersect. So we got the intersection piece, so select that with the eye picker and shift and alt press, just select this color. That's the color we are using in the gradient. You can see it's both sides we have used white color, but here the opacity is 100 and here 0. So with the gradient tool, just adjust the gradient colors like that, and in the opacity reduce it to 150%. So here we got that. Now we have added the gradient color, we have added everything. Now with the text, so we'll use the D for the text and type out our text. So G U A R D guard, make sure it's capital. So we can also do that by selecting this will use the guard. So here we got one more option here, we are using that. It's this option is to maintain the gap between the two alphabets. So we are giving around 1500 points, that's the gap between them, and you can see it's there. Now we'll select that and make sure the color of that is light gray, little bit of gray color, and this one will just scale this on a little bit, and we'll place this our text here. And the text which we are using is Ravi, R-A-V-I, which have already played it here. So we have created a text and we have added all our gradient colors which were needed. We have added a glossy effect, and overall we have completed our logo. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next video coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.